Today I'm introducing you, Disney's Raya and the Last Dragon. These 10 things you should know about the upcoming princess movie. Number 10. This film is made by the same studio as Moana and Frozen, which fans hope means more great songs and impressive graphics. It leaves others asking how, for this reason, it can relate to the other two films. There's a lot of focus on this film to see that Disney hasn't launched a new Disney princess since 2016 when Moana was introduced to the world. Number 9, Kelly Marie Tran and Awkwafina are both here in this movie, so it's sure to be a success. Awkwafina will be a dragon's voice called Sisu, and the fans will probably recall her from Mad Rich Asians and Ocean's 8. Raya, the princess herself, is going to be the voice of Kelly Marie Tran. Between these two actresses, there is no question that this film is going to be epic. Number 8, it's set in a fantasy universe called Kumandra. Kumandra is a fantasy world created by Disney, but most of it was focused on the cultures of Southeast Asia. The world they want is lush and green, but her journey takes her to the desert to change the scenery, which is why she could be one of the best Disney princess movies. Number 7, her sidekick looks like a large-armed hamster. There is no other description for Tuk Tuk apart from the fact that he looks like a giant hamster in armor identical to that of an armadillo. Others have described him as a giant pill bug because of the way he can jump around by rolling into a ball. Number 6, she was going to become a protector of the dragon gem. Raya's father is the leader of the Kumandra, which is why she has been trained since childhood to become the guardian of the dragon gem. These plans, however, changed as the world moved to something different, and their fate totally changed. Number 5. Raya is a fantastic warrior. A large part of Raya's preparation was in the area of hand-to-hand fighting with both sticks and knives. She's nimble and come on her feet, as well as a challenge when it comes to war. Raya was training to stop at nothing to protect the dragon gem, and her abilities show this attitude, which is why she could be the best Disney princess ever. Number 4. Its people are divided into 5 classes. The shift in land has led to the people of Kumandra breaking up into 5 separate communities that can be identified by their different colors. The guards wear brown, while the other classes can be seen wearing orange, pink, gray and tan. Number 3. Monsters called the Jun are their rivals. There is no singular villain for Raya to battle, at least not that fans know about, as it is a set of monsters that threaten the people of Kumandra. They were called the Jun and had invaded the land before, but the dragons had taken care of them for the first time. Number 2. It's up to her to locate the last dragon. There is one last dragon left to help stop the Jun if they ever returned, and his name is Sisu. It's a blue dragon and the last one that has the potential to turn into a human being, which may make it better than the Mulan Mushu. Raya is the one who has been charged with locating this dragon called Sisu. Number 1. It's coming to theaters and Disney and Premiere Access March 5, 2021. It offers people the chance to watch it from the comfort of their own home, or to spend the night in a city at the theater to watch the newest addition to the Disney Princess lineup.
Of the dragon gem. But this world has changed. And its people are divided. peace. I must find the last dragon. My name is Raya. Tuck, tuck. You're getting a little too big for this, bud.